Hello, welcome to another episode of This, That, and the Other. Today I'm going to be doing my annual review of the Baltimore Ravens 2019 draft picks and how I thought they did on it. I like this song, Rainbows to the End Zone. I remember hearing it quite a bit on NFL films. I'm going to get through part of this song because I like this part coming up. How the Ravens did this year. Round one, number 25 overall, Marquise Brown, a wide receiver out of Oklahoma. The 30th rated passer last season, 84.5 among quarterbacks with at least 100 attempts. At very least, Brown will force defenses not to stack the box against the heavy run Baltimore offense. Brown averaged 17.5 yards per reception and led the Power 5 conferences with 8 touchdowns on 25 yards and or longer. Concerned about his size, being only 5'10 and 175 pounds. Yeah, I'm used to receivers being about 6'5 or over so they can catch in a crowd. I don't know if they might be using him also as a tailback. Maybe, I don't know. Third round. Number 85 overall, Jalen Ferguson, defensive end, offensive linebacker at Louisiana Tech. After losing Terrell Suggs, Baltimore gets a player who broke Suggs' Division I record with 45 career sacks. Nicknamed Sack Daddy, Ferguson led the FBS with 17.5 sacks last season and recorded pressure on 19.1% on his pass rushes, which ranked second behind Josh Allen. Third round, pick number 93, Miles Boykin, a receiver out of Notre Dame, another receiver. Boykin provides more size, 6'3", 220 pounds. He led Notre Dame in receptions, 59, receiving yards, 872, and touchdown catches, 8. Boykin has a nose for the end zone. His streak of 6 consecutive games with a touchdown is the longest by a Notre Dame wide receiver since Will Fuller in 2014. This upgrades what had been one of the most suspect wide receiver groups in the NFL. Round 4, 113th overall pick, Justice Hall, running back, Oklahoma State. Justice Hall, who ran 40 in 4.40 seconds, is the type of home run back that Coach John Harbaugh wanted heading into the draft. His explosiveness complements the power running styles of Mark Ingram and Gus Edwards. He produced 13 games with 100-plus rushing yards over the last two seasons, tied with Iowa State's David Montgomery for most in the Big 12. Hill joins receivers Marquise Brown and Miles Boykin in a draft where Baltimore has focused on upgrading its offensive skills positions. This marks the first time the Ravens have ever drafted a player from Oklahoma State. Round 4, 123rd overall pick, Ben Powers, another player out of Oklahoma, an offensive guard. He was a 67th graded guard by Pro Football Focus. The Ravens love Oklahoma players, and Powers is the fourth Sooner to get taken by Baltimore in the last two drafts. Powers is close friends with Orlando Brown Jr., the Ravens' starting right tackle last year. ESPN's Todd McShay projects Powers to be a starting NFL guard. Another one in round 4, 127th overall pick, Iman Marshall, cornerback, USC. Ravens love Marshall's ability to play the ball, 36 pass breakups, and physicality and tackling, where Marshall has to improve upon his penalties. He was flagged 16 times in the past two seasons. Marshall has no interceptions the past 2 years. The addition of Marshall continues a trend for Baltimore. The Ravens have selected 6 cornerbacks in the last 5 drafts, and 4 of them have been taken in the 4th round. 5th round, 160th overall pick, Dalen Mack, defensive tackle, Texas A&M. The number 6 recruit entering Texas A&M, Mack struggled with stamina before an impressive season last year. He recorded 5.5 sacks and 9.5 tackles for a loss. Round 6, 197th overall pick, Trace McSorley, quarterback, Penn State. The Ravens decided to draft a third-string quarterback behind Lamar Jackson and RG3, Robert Griffin III. So while Baltimore sees McSorley as a quarterback first, Penn State's all-time leading passer might have to play different roles, such as Hill did last season for New Orleans Saints. McSorley was the fastest quarterback in the NFL Combine, might have to excel in a do-it-all role to make the Ravens' 53-man roster behind quarterbacks Lamar Jackson and Robert Griffin III. Baltimore has only carried the three quarterbacks in the regular season once in the past nine seasons. McSorley finished as the career record holder at Penn State for wins 31, completions 720, passing yards 9,899, touchdown passes 77, as well as rushing yards 1,697, and rushing touchdowns 30 by quarterback. But there have been skepticism whether he can play quarterback in the NFL because of his lack of size, 6 feet, and inconsistency in throwing the ball, 59.2% for his college career. I just wonder if they might be planning on using him more as a receiver or running back. He's probably going to be one of these people that kind of like who was that guy at Pittsburgh that they would throw and roll in different roles. I can't think of the guy's name right now. Pittsburgh Steelers quarterback that was drafted several years ago. Oh well, name will come to me. But anyway, that's what I was able to see on the 2019 Baltimore Ravens draft. Like, subscribe, share. As always, thanks for watching. Cordell Stewart, that was the one I was thinking of. That was the quarterback. Name finally came to me. I have a request to do one on the Orang Indians. That's going to be my next YouTube video. I don't usually discuss what the next one's going to be, but football season is right around the corner. In a few months, a couple months, you're going to see the first preseason games, and then the NFL season will be back again in full swing. And I'm excited about the Ravens season. They made the playoffs last year. Let's see if they can get in the playoffs again and this time win a playoff game, even go farther into the playoffs. Thank you for watching.